for Larry King Live. Now, Rachel, your photo appeared on the cover of New York Post just days after 9/11. Take me through what happened we're looking at that picture. That was now a day or so later.
Yeah, it was about 3 days.
3 days later. Take me through what happened from the last time you talked to your boyfriend till we see you on that magazine.
So I was working at Bloomberg News at the time, and Andy worked on the 104th floor of the tower that was the second one hit. So I spoke to him on the phone because we were covering it for news, of course. And I got him on the phone, and I tried to talk to him about what he was seeing. Everything he was talking to me about, though, I was reporting to our control room, and it was being reported by our anchor on the news. So, you know, I was really focused on news, and I had no idea that Andy would ever be hurt or part of this. I had spoken to Andy, and the second time I spoke to him, he said that he was going to be leaving the building. He sounded a little bit out of breath, and as I went to hang up the phone, there was another explosion, and I realized when I looked at the monitors around our control room, that there had been, you know, another plane that went in, and I was still holding the phone, so I knew that Andy was still obviously on his floor. The plane had hit well below where he was working. I could see that. So I was able to calculate, you know, where he would be, and I figured he would either be running up to get to the roof or possibly going to be figuring out a way to get down. And again, nobody knew to even be able to fathom the building's falling. So I really wasn't scared for him. Of course, I was anxious, and everybody felt very anxious about the situation, but I never had any idea this would be the last moment that I spoke to him. And about 45 minutes later, I was standing at my desk, and I watched the building fall, and at that moment knew that I had just watched my fiance die, and I couldn't find the chair behind me, and I just sunk down to the floor and sat there.
Ugh, these stories are just so awful. You and I went down to 9/11 about a year ago. You and I went down to Ground Zero about a year ago, and you actually met a man who had lost his wife.
Yeah.
Let's look at that footage.
I don't know you. My name is Nick Charles, and I lost my wife and my niece here also. And I'm surprised I don't know you. I'm a docent here. And I was wondering who the heck you were, and I said, they said, well, she lost a fiance, and I said, oh my God, I said, I lost my wife and my niece here.
I'm so sorry.
Me too, I'm sorry for you too.
Wait, did your wife work there?
Yeah, she worked for Fred Allergy Management, 93rd floor, Tower 1, so I lost my wife and my niece.
We were just talking, and she was just saying how no one can ever really know what that is.
I do, that's why I interrupted, I'm so sorry. I can cry too.
I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry.
What was it like for you finding somebody who'd been through almost the same experience?
When you meet somebody that has lost somebody in that same capacity, you know what they're feeling and they know what you're feeling.
So, and really nobody else does. We think we do, but we really
just
don't.
Yeah, and it's hard also to express that to people and to have him look at me and say, I lost my wife, my beloved wife, and to see the tears, you know, well in his eyes, and he just wanted to hug me. I will forever have a connection to that man, you know, and know what he went through.
Now, David.